When I arrived in South Africa to look at the rising star foot bones for the first time, I was absolutely floored. We can learn so much more about locomotion if you have bones from a single individual. And not only did we have 107 foot bones, we had 121 pieces of leg bones. We had a really good chance to understand in great detail, perhaps more detail than ever, how one of these early human species were moving. The foot and leg are some of the best ways that you can tell how our early ancestors were walking, and walking on two legs is unique to humans. What you're looking at here are just a few of the over 1,500 fossils that were excavated from the Homo naledi chamber of Rising Star Cave in South Africa. These are replicas, however. When I first started looking at the rising star material, I was stunned by how human-like it was. In fact, it was more human-like than any other fossils that we had looked at, short of fossils from Neanderthals or early Homo sapiens. And so although these were quite small and from small creatures, their foot anatomy was strikingly like humans today. But there are some subtle differences. The arch of the foot, at least in this one individual that we have a complete foot from, appears to be a little lower than in most humans today, so she would have been somewhat flat-footed by human standards, modern human standards. And their toes are a little more curved than human toes are today. One of my favorite fossils is a tibia, it's a shin bone, and it's from a child who died and left this absolutely extraordinarily complete tibia. This is a very rare kind of fossil to have because we can learn a lot about how these creatures grew and whether their growth was more like humans today or more ape-like, and that helps us understand when the modern human growth spurt evolved potentially. But this shin bone, as well as some other shin bones that we found in the collection, they're long, they're very long. And this tells us that by this point in human evolution, we have these long-legged creatures. And we know from experimental studies that long-legged animals can travel greater distances using less energy. What was really fascinating about this creature was that even though the foot and the leg were so human-like, there were other aspects of its anatomy that weren't. It was clear that this was a different species, that this was a different kind of human that nobody had seen before. These fossils are going to be studied for centuries, and new fossils are going to be coming out of this cave constantly. We're going to know a lot about this creature, probably more about this creature than any of the other early humans that have ever been discovered. We've never been able to work with this volume of material before, and we're able to assess and to quantify variation in foot bones, in leg morphology, in ways we've never been able to do before with the human fossil record. This is just a unique and extraordinary sight and an amazing discovery.